Google Tasks is not an application used by many, but I did want to showcase 5 different tips for Google Tasks for those of you that may be interested in trying out this free software. If you go to the 3 dots on Google Tasks, you actually can see keyboard shortcuts. And these keyboard shortcuts are pretty solid. You can do, for example, nice up and down movement, indentation for tasks, adding subtasks by pressing Control Alt and Return. So if I press Control Backslash here, it will open the keyboard shortcuts and then I can exit out of it. So if I press an add task here and I press Control Alt Enter, that made it so that I could make a subtask. And then if I wanted to, I could press Control and then the left bracket and that would move it in, and then the right bracket and that would move it out. So there is a little bit of keyboard shortcut functionality. So I'd recommend you pressing Control and Backslash to figure out what those are for you. Now, number 2, I would recommend using lists. What people don't understand in Google Tasks is that there actually is a feature set allowing you to use lists, and lists are important for categorizing things. As you can see, I have the growth, life, work, and rise productive parts of my life. So I could do that correspondingly with my different task lists. I could make a growth task list. I could make a life task list, so that essentially whenever I'm in different time blocks, I could, for example, have this side hustle be record videos. And then once going into the work time section, I could have work tasks here, and you can move between different lists by pressing the 3 dots right here. My next tip for this would be integrate this with your time blocking. So if I were to take this task and press enable tasks here, this is a calendar that is made on your Google Calendar. And then if I were to take this guy, drag it here, you could have a custom color for this specific tasks. And this blue is different than everything else I would have. So essentially I could take this and place it in a specific spot. Now, the only thing that I do not like about this integration is the fact that you can't change the duration of how long tasks will take. So for example, I could make a time block that's as long as I wanted to, but I could not take a task and do anything but change the start time. And that's not something I'm really a fan of. So if I were to take this task and delete it, it would delete it from the task list and my calendar as well. So I personally, if I were gonna use this, would only use it as a reference point, maybe actually only even have it in the list, because I'm not really a fan of the fact that you're not allowed to change the duration. Now, a view that actually helps you see your task better is if you go to your Google Calendar and press A, or you go to this drop down and find it here, you can get a different view of your task list. So if I were to get rid of these guys here, or even as an example, because I don't want to have these different time blocks interrupting what my tasks are, you'll see that if I added a few different tasks here, example task, and made it go at today at 10:30 a.m. You'll see that this is a view where you could see different things. Like, let's say I add my Calendly, which is my meetings. So it would showcase the different meetings that I were to have and the tasks I would have. And the schedule view is particularly helpful if you just want a quick overview of your to-dos for the day and what times that you associated with them. Now, the last thing I'll recommend is adding an extension to utilize board views with your Google Tasks. Because when I've used Google Tasks, it's really not that fun to work in anything that doesn't have tags or a board view or something like that. So as you'll see, there is the example task from today. And this is a different view of the list that you have. And I personally think this is a little bit more digestible than other views, especially the calendar view that you have is only mildly digestible. I'm not a huge fan of it. There is this vertical view that you can have and this board view you can have in this example Google Tasks Chrome extension. It has a lot of users and a lot of positive ratings. So I would recommend checking out something like this in order to improve your Google Tasks. And I would also recommend checking out this video to see how you can improve your productivity even more.